have had the experience of being in the association of persons who hold to be gurus, but they're not gurus at all. So how do we reconcile and deal with the situation? Because, you know, sometimes history repeats itself. How do we, like if we notice and see things ourselves in a person that's supposed to be initiating within Guru Day Sangha, and we should get the gist of it all.
Okay. So, I think I'll try to reply that in two ways. Number one, you mean may have me as a separate person, not the disciple. How to help that disciple is your question?
Well, like if we see, for instance, I can maybe tell my experience quickly. I was initiated by someone, and they eventually fell down, had been falling down for a long time, and it was known to many. And then when I approached persons and I asked the question, well, how is it that you let this happen, that you let us come to this person, you knew? So I'm saying, so if we know certain things are going on with persons who are taking disciples, how should we, can you give some advice how we can deal with that kind of situation?
Okay. If somebody has faith in that person, as we've seen from long ago, when somebody had faith in a person who was actually fallen, and we tried to upset that faith, then there would immediately be a wall between them and us, and then they would go back and tell their guru, and their guru would make all kinds of propaganda against us and against Guru. So that didn't seem to work. Unless the person already doesn't have faith, then you can support that and bring that person to an actual advanced devotee for shiksha, and then they may ultimately take diksha from them. So what I do now is, whoever a person's guru is, unless they tell me I completely lost faith, then it's another thing. But if anybody tells me in a happy way that this is my Gurudev, I immediately just say, wonderful, that's great. And mostly, it is great. I'm happy. Even if by my conception, that person is not the topmost level guru. Because I know some things which I already mentioned and which I'll continue to mention in a couple of minutes. And then I'm friends with them, right? Great, wonderful, and I say something good about their guru, in sincerity or not sincerity, depending. And then I'm friends with them, and then I can tell them anything I want. Then I can tell them about Gurudev, then I can tell them about any other person that, by my conception, is a Nuttama Mahabhagavat. They can come and meet just to have nice association. Then I can teach them whatever I know about bhakti. And in other words, nobody's stuck. It's not the end of the world if you don't have a good guru. Nobody's stuck. Because he can associate with others who can help him advance. And gradually, if he's sincere, he'll come to the proper line. But I don't want to block myself by saying your guru is bad, and then all kinds of horrible things happened with me in the past, so I don't do that anymore. Then many of Gurudev's disciples who are giving initiation, they are associating with a personality or personalities who many of Srila Gurudev's followers and Prabhupada's followers consider to be Uttama Adhikari. So those gurus are advancing, and their disciples are being invited to directly associate with that Uttama Adhikari or those Uttama Adhikaris. For example, Vasanti and I and many hundreds of Gurudev's followers and disciples in India, particularly, visit Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, who is a very intimate friend of Srila Gurudev and a disciple of Srila Bhakti Dwaita Madhav Maharaj, who is a disciple of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So many of our Gurudev's disciples and Prabhupada's disciples who are with Srila Gurudev, who are giving initiation, I would say, I would venture to say even at least 3/4 of them are also having darshans with Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. So it's not that we want to cheat the disciples like we used to and say, oh yes, your disciple, your guru, even though we knew so many things, yes, your guru was the sum total of all demigods, like Isha Prabhu said, Gurudev said about himself yesterday. But we can easily say nice things. But at the same time, like you said, if you're, what is analogy did you give? Oh yeah, if your doctor isn't good, tell us about it. Yeah. Right. So, I forgot what I was going to say. If that guru is not pure, then, the disciple is not obliged, and we're not obliged. Gurudev said also, we're not obliged to glorify anyone's particular guru who we don't personally acknowledge as bona fide. We don't, as we discussed, we don't necessarily discourage them unless they're already totally discouraged. But we don't go with any pretending. But Gurudev explained, I mean, it's in the scriptures too, especially it's in the first part of Pinnacle of Devotion, where it says, if you made a mistake and accepted somebody who's not a pure devotee, and then you realize later, and then you find a pure devotee, then you can say to that non-pure devotee, I found a pure devotee, can I associate with him? Can I have your blessings to associate with him? And if he's really sincere, if he's really Majjhima Adhikari, he'll say, oh yes, there is one that I'm going to, or just yes, please go. And if he says no, then you know that you offer obeisances, I mean, give your pranam, thank you very much, and leave him, and it's not an offense. So it's not that if one doesn't think his guru is uttama, and because one should, it doesn't mean that he needs to force himself to, if he's getting some realization or saying things that make him realize he isn't. But at that time, because one should see one's guru as an uttama adhikari, if he doesn't, it means it's time to get a new guru. But if he's going to keep that one, although I got a letter from one of our guard brothers who's initiating, and he said, well, me and a few other of our god brothers who initiate, and we asked our disciples, do you think that we're uttama adhikari? And they said, no, but we have full faith in you. So if that's the way they want to do it, they can do it that way. But the disciples at the same time know that they're taking higher instructions. And if anybody here is coming to India and is interested, the sadhu can arrange that if you'd like, you can get a darshan with Srila Bharati Maharaj. A little commercial there.
I have experience with Gurudev on this matter. My wife was taken hearing the Diksha mantras in Australia in 2001, and I was standing outside the door where Gurudev was doing, and he came outside the door, and we were like nose to nose, and he was like, "You have caused me to make great offense," and I was like shocked, you know, like, "What did I do? What did I do?" He said, never say that I have given her diksha. Say that I'm giving her shiksha. He says, I have so much love and affection for Satsarup Maharaj. I don't want to offend him. And everybody knew, you know, Satsuru was having problems and going away. So this was Gurudev's mood. And then we really don't know what is in the heart of the other Vaishnava. I later learned that some of Satsuru's disciples, when